Hello friends, today we'll take a look at the latest IPO that is hitting the market. It's of Indigo Paints. Now this IPO has generated a lot of interest among investors because it is the first time in more than two decades that we are having a paint company that is getting listed.
Yay!
Sambhal!
धोनी भाई मैं ठीक हूँ।
अरे तू नहीं, मेरा फ्लोर।
फ्लोर भी ठीक है।
इंडिगो फ्लोर पेंट, सब कुछ सहे, सालों साल चले।
इंडिगो फ्लोर पेंट।
इंडिगो।
हाय, अब तुम्हारी बाइक पे? धोनी भाई रुको तो।
As you saw in this advertisement, the company has quite a few differentiated products, such as floor coatings, metallic emulsions, tile coat emulsions, and bright ceiling coat emulsions. Now, these products set apart its product portfolio from that of the peers. Also, first things first, we have a subscribe rating on the IPO. Let me say it right at the outset. We advise investors to subscribe to the IPO for listing gains, and once you have gains in place, you may either choose to stay invested in Indigo or move to Asian Paints or Berger if they are available at reasonable valuations. However, make sure that you have exposure to the paint sector, as it has been one of the biggest wealth creators for the past several years. Now, quick reasons why we feel that you should subscribe to the IPO. The company has a strong and qualified promoter in place who has steered robust growth over the years. The paint sector has been an extremely strong wealth creator over the years. Then the repainting cycle has shortened from 7 to 8 years to 4 to 5 years currently. And the sector has a strong entry barrier by way of presence of well-entrenched 4 players. Now, Indigo has managed to not only penetrate this space dominated by stalwarts, but has also managed to grow at a very hectic pace. The financial performance has improved over the years, with margins and return ratios inching closer to 2 out of the 4 players. Indigo has also played it smart by grabbing market share from smaller unorganized players in the rural areas rather than taking larger players head on. So let us now take a look at the offer. The issue is worth 1170 crores at the higher price band. It comprises of a fresh issue of 300 crores and offer for sale of 870 crores by PE fund Sequoia Capital, which has been invested since FY15. The price band is 1488 to 1490. The issue opens for subscription on 19 January for anchor investors and for the general public between 20th Jan and 22nd Jan. So out of the fresh issue of 300 crores, rupees 150 crore will be used for capacity expansion at Tamil Nadu, 50 crores for purchasing tinting machines, 25 crores for loan repayment, and the remaining 75 crores for general corporate purposes. Even after the OFS, Sequoia's stake in the company will remain at 28%, while promoter stake will become 54%. So now a brief about Indigo. Now, it is the fifth largest paint company in India by revenues. It has three manufacturing facilities in Rajasthan, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu. The total manufacturing capacity across these plants is a little more than 1 lakh kiloliter per annum for liquid paints and close to 1 lakh metric tons per annum for putty and powder paints. The company also has a differentiated product portfolio comprising of metallic emulsions, tile coat emulsions, bright ceiling coat emulsions, and floor coat, which contribute 28% to the total revenues. Now, the paint industry in India was worth approximately 500 billion rupees in FY20. It is expected to grow at 12 to 13% over the longer term. Unorganized and localized players comprise 30% of this market, and these are the players with which Indigo mainly competes. That is because Indigo's presence is higher in tier 2 and 3 areas where unorganized players are present prominently, apart from national level players as well. Also, the tier 2-3 areas constitute 50% of the total demand. Hence, Indigo's major endeavor is to grab market share from the unorganized players. The company, incorporated in 2000, is led by Mr. Hemant Jalan, who is the chairman and the managing director. It has a professional management in place and eminent board members. So, what are these points that make us positive on the company? Firstly, revenue growth has been fastest among peers over the past many years. In fact, over the past decade, obviously owing to the low base. Even in FY20, the growth rate for the company was higher than peers. This is due to Indico's strategy of focusing on tier 2 to 3 areas which were less affected by the pandemic. Secondly, Indico has gross margins comparable to peers due to a differentiated product portfolio which I mentioned earlier. These products are sold without discounts which aid margins. Indico has been advertising heavily. That is, it has invested heavily in advertising and promotion to create a strong brand for itself. These A&P expenses are about 2 to 3 times those of peers if I compare it with respect to percentage of sales. Now, this is expected to go down to less than 10% of sales in the coming years as economies of scale kick in. The company has roped in MS Dhoni as its brand ambassador, given the resonance that Dhoni has across the country without any regional bias. Also, all its products are sold under the Indico brand against different brands for other peers. This is intended to reinforce the brand Indico in the minds of consumers. Now, the company's efforts in growing profitably without too much of debt are reflected in its return ratios, which have grown significantly over the years. Now, some of the challenges that Indico could face are, firstly, it will have to continue to face competition from well-established and well-entrenched players, and hence it will have to keep investing behind the brand to stay relevant. Dealers, especially in urban and metro areas, could ask for higher margins from Indico, given that it has a low brand equity. Also, increasing tinting machines could be a challenge, as a single dealer can keep only 1 to 2 tinting machines in his or her shop. Everything said, it is still commendable to note that Indico has managed to create a niche for itself in a sector that is dominated by 4 large players: Asian Paints, Berger Paints, Kansai Nerolac and AkzoNobel. If we look at the financials of the company, we find that Indigo's valuations are at 20 to 30% discount to Asian Paints and Berger. Given that a company is solely focusing on decorative paints, valuations are comparable to Kansai and at a slight premium to AkzoNobel. Given the high growth rates and improving return ratios and margins, we feel that the valuations are justified. However, the company will have to keep growing profitably at the current pace in order to justify these valuations going ahead. Hence, we advise investors to subscribe to the IPO for listing gains, and once you have gains in place, you may either choose to stay invested in Indigo or move to Asian Paints or Berger if they are available at reasonable valuations. Thank you and have a good day ahead.